How to make the best Oreo cake recipe.
Go ahead and combine together your flour, your baking powder, and your salt, and give it a whisk. And combine the milk, the oil, and the clear vanilla. Cream until smooth. Once it looks light and fluffy like this, you can go ahead and start adding in your egg whites. Fold in your Oreo cookies. Go ahead and prepare 3 6-inch cakes with cake goop or whatever pan release you like. Go ahead and divide your batter evenly between your three pans. Bake in the oven at 335 degrees for 25 to 30 minutes.
And that's...
I'm sure you all know that one chocolate cake in Matilda where the kid Bruce had to eat it all and you were low-key jealous because it looked so good. Well, here's how you can make it at home. Luckily for you guys, it's literally the easiest chocolate cake recipe you'll ever try. You just mix all the dry ingredients, throw in the eggs and melted butter, and then pour in some hot coffee. And don't worry, this doesn't leave any coffee taste behind, it just helps bring out the chocolate flavour and take us to the next level. So once you get this runny smooth batter, go ahead and bake it, and then while it cools you can make the ganache. You heat some cream in the microwave, pour it on the chocolate, mix it together, and then once it's cooled you should get this really creamy spreadable ganache. And then you can just spread it between and all over the cake layers and you're done. Just look at how good that looks. I didn't even put my blood, sweat and tears in it, but I still feel like Miss Trunchbull would be proud. If you've been looking for a super easy and super moist chocolate cake recipe, then you need to try this. I'm not exaggerating when I say that this is foolproof, and all you have to do is whisk all of your dry ingredients in a bowl. Once you've done that, just pour in some melted butter and some whisked eggs and give it a light mix. Then take some instant coffee granules, put it in some hot milk and pour that in and stir everything together. You should get a super smooth and light batter consistency. Then just pour it into a buttered and floured tin. Go ahead and bake it in the oven, and then while it cools, you can start your chocolate ganache. And this is just as easy, you add some hot cream to some chocolate, let it sit, and then give it a mix. I added some Nutella spread, and then I poured the ganache, and I was done. This is so decadent and so rich, and it really reminds me of that cake that's in the Matilda movie.
If there's one cake you need to know how to make, it's this 5-ingredient sponge cake. You can make so many different types of desserts with. In a bowl, add 6 large room temperature eggs, then beat on high for 2 minutes, then add 1 cup of sugar. Now you can go ahead and add the vanilla extract or orange powder, then beat on high for 10 minutes until it gets thick and fluffy. Now go ahead and sift in your dry ingredients, all-purpose flour and baking powder. Sift it in 2 parts, and then fold it into the batter, gently making sure not to deflate the batter. Then go ahead and divide the batter between 2 9-inch cake pans. Then bake at 350 Fahrenheit for 25 minutes. That's it. Enjoy.
Okay, so this is my really easy marble cake recipe. If you fancy making this, all you need is some softened butter and caster sugar. Just beat those until it's creamed together like this. Slowly add the eggs and keep whisking in between until you've got a mixture that looks like this. Pour in the milk, vanilla essence, add the self-raising flour and fold it through until you've got a cake batter that looks like this. Divide it between 2 mixing bowls, add cocoa powder into one of them and mix it in. Then you've got 2 different sponge mixes. Now what you want to do is just alternate like this, 1 spoon of one, then a spoon of the other, until you have used up all of the mix. Give it a tap and a shake and then get it into the oven for 55 minutes at 160 degrees. You can check it's cooked by sticking a skewer in the middle. If it comes out clean, it's ready. Get it onto a cooling rack, let it cool.
Oh, Here's how to make a Lotus Biscoff cake with just three ingredients. Add melted Biscoff and baking powder to a bowl and mix until combined. Add two eggs and mix well until thick. Pour the mix into your cake tin and smooth it out, then bake in the oven. Once cool, pour on some more Biscoff spread, letting it drip down the edges, then top with some Biscoff crumbs if you wish. Enjoy!
If you want a vanilla cake recipe that isn't dry, carry on watching this video. This recipe is from Broma Bakery and it's honestly the best vanilla cake I've ever had. First of all, you want to sift all your dry ingredients together. Then you want to mix the butter and oil for 3 minutes until it's emulsified. The butter needs to be really soft, otherwise this isn't going to work. If your butter is too hard, it's just going to clump up. You're going to see it's not going to be soft like the video I'm about to show. So if that does happen, you can just heat it over a bain-marie. Next, you add in a little bit of sugar at a time and whisk again for 3 minutes until it's pale. Next, you want to add each egg one at a time, and in between each egg, you want to scrape down the bowl as well. Then you add in the vanilla extract and beat again for 3 minutes. Next, you're going to add the buttermilk and the flour mixture in four stages. So it's going to go buttermilk, flour, buttermilk, flour, buttermilk, flour, buttermilk, flour. Don't overmix this. It's okay if you have a couple of lumps, and look how airy and fluffy this is. It's so moist and delicious. Throw away any other vanilla recipe you have.
Today we're making quite possibly the best and easiest chocolate cake recipe you'll ever have. And it also reminds me of Matilda, which makes it that much more amazing in my opinion. So let's get right into the recipe. To begin, we're going to start off by adding in all of our dry ingredients into a clean bowl. And we're going to mix that all together until well incorporated. And then we're going to add in our wet ingredients. You initially want to start off with your milk and your egg and then roughly mix it together and then add in the rest of your ingredients. Now, you don't want to overmix, so just whisk it together until it's nice and smooth. And you want to add your batter into 2 6-inch prepared baking pans. And we're going to bake at 350 for about 35 to 40 minutes. While our cake is baking, we're going to mix together our ganache. And all you need is a half a cup of chocolate chips, as well as 1 cup of simmered heavy cream. And mix it together until it's smooth. It might take a minute or two, but once it is smooth, you can set it to the side. I like to set mine in the fridge because I like it to be more stiff. Once my cake came out of the oven, I allowed it to completely cool, and then I trimmed off the top layer to make it nice and straight, and then I smothered it in my ganache, and I topped it with some raspberries as well as some cacao nibs, and you're done.